Can you hear this? I wonder if my mic is gonna pick this up. Hello friends, it is time for another book box unboxing because the Fairy Loot March box has just arrived. Fairy Loot is a subscription box that focuses on YA fantasy, so they include a book every month and then some bookish items. And so far, I don't think Fairy Loot has ever disappointed me with their book picks. I mean, I like the majority of them. I don't like every book they pick. The theme for the March box is Frozen Fables, and we can expect items inspired by The Bear and the Nightingale, Winter Song, Spinning Silver, Wicked Saints, Winterwood, and even The Darkest Stars. And I feel like I say this in every video, but I haven't read any of these books. I know some of them, but I haven't read them. I was really impressed with their previous boxes, so I'm really excited to see what is inside this one. And if you like these kind of videos, then don't forget to click that subscribe button and hit that bell so you never miss another video of me again. Let's get unboxing. Just in case anyone is gonna notice, I have a really big bruise on my hand. I'm just clumsy like that. I played tennis this morning and somehow instead of hitting the ball, I hit my own hand. That happens. As always, the spoiler card is probably on top and beneath that, a big box. So I'm gonna guess that this is the ceramic mug. They give us a little spoiler that there would be a mug inside the March box. As always, the back of the spoiler card holds the art print of this month. We can see a snow king and queen in front of this amazing looking castle. Before I'm gonna grab the first item, I wanna say thank you to my patrons. You help me keep this channel running. And if you feel like it is something for you, then definitely come join us. Just head over to patreon.com and type in my name, Leanna Brooks, or click on the link in my description. Seeing as I already mentioned it, I'm gonna go for the ceramic mug first. So this is inspired by The Bear and the Nightingale. I know the book cover and I kind of know what it is about, and I'm really curious to see this design. Ooh, it is blue on the inside. There's a snowflake on the inside. That is so cute. And the design, oh my gosh. Okay, yeah, I'm in love. This is my new favorite mug. This is beautiful. I don't know the characters, but I feel like this could be the two main characters of The Bear and the Nightingale. There's a woman with beautiful long black hair, and she is standing in front of a guy that also has black hair, and he is standing next to a white horse. And I think we can see some kind of forest in the background. And of course, a lot of snow. And what's always a plus with the Fairy Loot mugs is that they are microwave and dishwasher safe. Great first item. Next up is something soft. I feel like this could be a headband. Let me be honest and say that I have no idea how to wear these. I am such a dork when it comes to makeup and headbands and stuff like that. I just don't know how to use them, but I feel like this is the back and this is the front and you just put it over your head. Kind of makes sense when it is a headband. And this headband is inspired by the Something Dark and Holy series by Emily A. Duncan. I can see a kind of Russian looking house, some birds, some pine trees, a lot of blue, some red and white. It's another really practical item that I think every girl needs. I mean, if I saw this in a shop, I wouldn't necessarily buy it because I am not a huge fan of the colors and the design. And it's based on a book series that I don't know. So I mean, I still like it as an item, but it's not up there with the ceramic mug. Then let's see, what do we have next? Ooh, do we have socks? Oh, I wanted them to be long socks. They are short socks. I mean, the theme is Frozen Till, so I was expecting like thick, warm socks. Let's see. Again, I don't really recognize the design. I mean, whenever I see mountains, I just think of the Night Court, so. But these are inspired by Even the Darkest Stars by Heather Fawcett. I mean, I like them. I like the colors. There's a wolf walking in the snow, or at least I think it's a wolf. And then in the background, we can see snowy mountains and a lot of stars. I've gone through quite a lot of socks lately. Most of them have holes in them, so I'm happy with socks. And I like that all the items have something blue, which is very appropriate for the theme. And it also really adds to the aesthetic of the box. Ooh, do we have a pin? Oh, this might not be a pin. It's a little bit bigger than their pin bags, but let's see what it is. Yes, I needed one of these. It is a phone ring holder inspired by Winterwood. I recognize the cover. They did a really nice job with this design. Be your own light. and there's a moon, some stars, and some branches. So I actually just treated myself to a new phone. This is an iPhone 12, and I still need something like a phone ring holder to put on my phone. That is gonna look so awesome. And this is exactly what I meant with practical items, because who doesn't need a phone ring holder? I don't know about the colors though, because this is mint green and this is silver with blue, but I'll make it work. What is this? It feels like a notebook. Oh, I love this. Oh, anything with foiling, like silver or gold foiling or even red foiling, like everything is better with foiling. Why is that? Probably because it's shiny, but okay. Focus. This reminds me of Beauty and the Beast because we got a rose within a snow globe. And then at the back, it says, a candle unused is nothing but wax and wick. I would rather light the flame, knowing it will go out, than sit forever in darkness. S.J. Jones. No idea, guys. Let's see. This stunning notebook is inspired by Winter Song. So that is another book I haven't heard of. So I could not tell you what it is about, but I like the artwork. And the notebook itself has blank pages. Okay, I thought all the items were out of this box, but then there was another item beneath the book pouch. And I think it's an art print, and I saw some foiling. Honestly, I got chills when I took a look at this. Is this inspired by Spinning Silver? So I haven't read that book, but it is on my TBR. The foiled art print is inspired by Spinning Silver by Naomi Novik. I really like how this looks, not only because of the silver foiling, but also just the art style. What do you guys do with these art prints? I hang on to the prettiest ones and I put them somewhere in my bookcase, like over there. I have one from Stardotter. I have another one over there, by the way, from the Raven Boys. And then the Raven Boys book is beneath that. So this one will also get a place somewhere in my bookcase. I can blind you guys with this print. I can blind myself with this print. This is, wow, shiny. And of course, the two tarot cards, and these are inspired by the Winter Night trilogy by Catherine Arden. Ace of Wands, Two of Wands. Oh, my hand really hurts, you guys. I feel like it's getting worse. And now the moment that we bookworms have waited for, the book pouch. It's blue. Oh, wow. Wow. The Bright and the Pale by Jessica Rubingowski. I've never heard of this book or this author, but I really like the cover. And I don't know if the camera is gonna pick this up, but the sprayed edges have a kind of shimmer to them. So one of the authors that recommends this book is Erin A. Craig, and she wrote The House of Salt and Sorrows. I unhauled that book, so I don't know if that's a good sign. 17-year-old Valeria is one of the only survivors of the Freeze, a dark magical hold, not mountain, unleashed on her village. Everyone, including her family, is trapped in an unbreakable sheet of ice. Ever since, she has been on the run from the Tsar, who is determined to imprison anyone who managed to escape. Valeria finds refuge with the Thieves Guild, doing odd jobs with her best friend, Alik, the only piece of home she has left. That is, until he is brutally murdered. A year later, she discovers Alik is alive and being held against his will. To buy his freedom, she must lead a group of cutthroats and thieves on a perilous expedition to the very mountain that claimed her family. Only something sinister slumbers in the heart of Nott, and it has waited years for release. Inspired by Russian folklore, Jessica Rubinkowski's epic fantasy debut is a thrilling page-turner with romance, tragedy, magic, and monsters that will stay with you to the very end. To the very end. That's a long time. Okay, so when I read that, I felt like there could be a dragon in this story. And I mean, a lot of good fantasy books are inspired by Russian folklore. So I'm really excited to read this. As with every Fairy Loot book, I'm gonna add it to my TBR. So in case you're interested in my book review, you can find those on my Instagram or my Goodreads. And we'll probably have a bookmark and an art print. The bookmark with the same art as on the spoiler card. We can see a tragic looking girl with white hair and a red dress, and I'm gonna assume that this is the main character, Valeria. And at the back, the letter from the author. I will give you guys a close-up, so if you want to read it, just pause the screen. And of course, the fairy scoop, in which you can find an interview with the author and next month's theme, and that is hidden identities. You might think you know who someone truly is, but what if they are keeping a secret that could change everything for the better or for the worse? As Phaedrus wisely said, things are not always what they seem. The first appearance deceives many. In this box, you can expect items by The Shadow Between Us, The Lord of the Rings, The City of Brass, Flame in the Mist, and a foil bookmark. Love those. Oh, sets, a foil bookmark set. That's even better. Inspired by the following fandoms: An Ember in the Ashes, The Poppy War, and Blood Air. For now, we won't be revealing any item artists, but we will say that we are featuring an item in this box that we have never, capital letters, never included before. Did get an email from Fairy Loot saying that one of the items will be replaced. Let me see. Here it is. I found it. The fandom has changed from The Shadows Between Us to From Blood and Ash. And that was everything in the Fairy Loot March box. We have seen a lot of blue items, including myself. Feel like I can do it this time. I can pick a favorite and a least favorite item. My favorite item is definitely the ceramic mug because I can always use a good mug and this just looks beautiful. And then my least favorite item is the headband, not because it is a headband, but because I don't know the fandom. That's all me. And I'm also not a fan of the colors and the design. As always, let me know your thoughts on this box. Did you have a favorite or maybe a least favorite item? And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and let's stay in touch.